So we're talking about the biomedical research in developing countries. Because as we all know, developing countries has different challenges than developed countries. Obviously, in the developed countries, fortunately, the system is much more mature than the situation in developing countries. Now, look at this. This is what I teach. I wrote gastroenterology and India. So I did a PubMed search for 3 big countries of the world to see how much literature they produced. And I wrote gastroenterology and India. This is called Boolean search. I think all of you know that. Boolean search means if I put a capital AND in PubMed, so if I write gastroenterology, capital A, capital N, capital D, and India, it will give me all the things, all the articles that have 2 things in common. One is gastroenterology and India. It gave me 7,160 result. I wrote gastroenterology and China. It gave me 26,872 result. I wrote gastroenterology and USA. It gave me 47,996 result. That means USA might have produced 47,996 paper in relation to gastroenterology. China has produced 26,872 papers, and India has produced 7,160 papers. So obviously, we need to go up. We need to go. So now, this is another document that said the countries leading the world in scientific publication. So which are the countries leading the world in scientific publication? China has something like 528,263 papers. 528,263 paper. Earlier was gastroenterology, so it was a narrow area, narrow field. Now here you can see scientific publication in general, China has produced 528,263. United States has produced 422,808. So US is second in position, and India has produced 135,788. Now the global share of scientific publication, China has given 21%, US has given around 16%. And India has given around 5.3%. So can somebody tell me, are we really in good situation now? Should we be happy because we are third in the world? Or if you are not happy, how can you improve upon this? Anybody?
We should be both happy as well as sad, because at least we are third, but it is not satisfactory. We should go up.
So why we are not going up? Why we are not going up?
Sir, personally, in my viewpoint, Indian mentality is that better research can be done by technology-based research, and we are still lagging behind in technology, sir.
Okay, so Ajay says we are lagging behind in technology. Anybody else has to say anything? Unmute and then speak. unmute and speak. Tushar, you have to say something. I can see Dr. Tushar Mondal. So Tushar, do you have to say something? Ajay says we might be lacking in technology and the research is only technology.
But there may be the multiple regions starting from the collection of the data to its interpretation and then publication at the all the front. Although the we are third, but considering the total number of the population of the country of the India, so we should be at the, because the it is the number of the patient that is going to create. And although United States has the
Arjun, Haji, very good.
The United States has a less number.
Yes,
less number of the population. Still, we are lagging behind the India. China, maybe we have the same number of the population, but still, we are 1/4 of the China. This is not justifiable.
So, what are the problem? Why are we not doing better? What is your viewpoint?
Sir, it is the first is the collection of the data. We do not collect the data. We do not proper document and collect all these data. So, my perception is that initially it is the collection or viewpoint from the starting only. We do not think of these all, maybe the research point. We do not have all these data, collection of these data, then synthesize this to have a research question and then going for the publication.
So very good. So it has brought out a lot of point. Very good. Okay, now let me tell you what are the challenges, because you said something. Like Dr. Ajay from KGMU said that actually we are lagging behind in technology. Okay, good. Second is Dr. Manish said we don't properly collect the data, we don't synthesize the data. So both the points are very, very important. But I also put out some more points. I say limited facilities for research. In fact, this refers to point by Dr. Manish. He said we don't do data collection well, and second is we don't synthesize the data. Means he's trying to say analyze the data. So that means why don't you do that? This is because maybe many of the Indian medical graduate or postgraduate don't receive adequate research education and training. So that's why we are doing all these sessions. And first three sessions are very general. These are more like stimulating session. Then we'll gradually go to little on the technology front. Second is limited funding. Do you agree with this, Dr. Manish?
Yes, sir.
That we have limited funding. So we have Indian Council of Medical Research, which is a funding body. We have Department of Science and Technology, which is a funding body, and Department of Biotechnology. These are the three main. But in addition, you have CSIR and all those. But what we are lacking is, like I have seen many of these European and American nations, what I found is they're very open about fund. So it is not only public or government fund, but also they generate huge amount of research funding through private funding bodies. But in India, it's typically private funding bodies, either they are not too much interested, or maybe we, the administrator or academician or the policymaker, made a roadblock to them. They can't enter into the system. Now, second is less time for healthcare personnel for research. You agree with it, Dr. Ajay?
Yes, sir. We are busy in a lot of clinical work, so we have less time for research.
So how many patients do you see, not during corona time, but otherwise per day?
Sir,
if I ask,
in my OPD, I think it was around 150 to 200 patients, sir.
So 150 to 200. That is what we also see. But only thing is, we have a few residents with us. I was talking with Nick Talley. Nick Talley was in Mayo Clinic, USA, and then now he has shifted to Australia. And I asked Nick, how many patients really you see? He said, I have to see a lot of patients. I see how many? He said, 4 or 5. I said, you see 4 or 5 patients a day. In my OPD day, I have to manage 200 patients a day. So he told, no, it is not 5 to 6 patients a day. I see 5 to 6 patients a week. So Nick said to me that I see 5 to 6 patients a week, okay? 5 to 6 patients a week. So obviously, as Ajay rightly mentioned, that we have to see a large number of patients. Clinical work is huge. And this is because we have a huge population and there is a lack of enough number of doctors for the huge population. And whatever may be the number of doctors, if the population is too huge, doctor-patient ratio is not going to be good. So population control is important. So you have less time for research. Then you have low priorities for research and lack of research culture. In most institute, there is lack of research culture. Okay?
Mr. Vasal, this
yes,
this data which year from 2015 or 16 or 19?
It is 18-19, but 18-19. But obviously, this is a cumulative data. Not that it in that year. It include previous year as well. You are referring to data of that India, China, and US.
This is number is increasing because from the third year in MBBS curriculum, we engage our students in a project, one kind of mini research.
But only thing is, Dr. Tusar, there is a problem. Problem is that yes, they produce something, but this is hardly ever published. So there is a tremendous gap between how much work you do and how much really get published in a standard journal. Don't talk about those predatory journal. So if we increase our number in predatory journal, actually our country's name will be in a more bad side rather than good side. So we are talking about standard journal. So what happens is, yes, what you are saying, Dr. Tusar, I fully agree. Like we have 18 students, DM students, and all of them have to do research. They do research, but hardly out of 18, maybe 3 or 4, finally you will see that it is published. And remaining 14, they have completed the work, but this is not published. And whatever data we are talking about, these are all published paper, not what work has been done. So the next point is low priorities of health research and lack of research culture. Inadequate effort for prioritization of research problem. So at least you do not see what is your country's priority. Because when we are asking research question, we must see what is our priority. It may not be always country's priority. It can be global priority also. Let us say if I know this is the priority of the globe now. Let us say if corona vaccine is the priority of the globe now. If we find corona protection from corona or prevention of the corona is priority now. Now, yes, if you do a work, it is a good work because it is likely to get attention of people more, because it is the priority for the country as well as the globe. So that sort of priority decision is not taken. There is a slowness of our system. Like our system is very slow. Ethical issues are there. There is limited health information, missing linkage, health inequalities, lack of incentive for research and publication bias. So does anybody have any point? Does anybody has any point on this issue? Because I will elaborate on each of these issues now. But what I will elaborate may be limited. Maybe you have some other points which you want to add to this. Or maybe when I elaborate on each of these, I might have missed something which you want to sort of draw my attention. No point.
So okay. Open access charges also pose a challenge for research? Open access charges for publication?
Yes, very good question. Yes, very good question. Let us say what you said is very right. Let us say if you are a researcher and if a lot of journal ask for money, like many journal now ask for $3,000.
Yeah.
Now let us say when you say $3,000, it comes to about 2 lakh Indian rupees. So we have a lot of question. One is, should you pay 2 lakh Indian rupees to publish a paper? That is one. Second is, do you have 2 lakh Indian rupees to publish a paper? I would say, and third is that if you had, now you would have more number of paper. Yes, I agree. But remember one thing here, there is a list of predatory journal. Predatory means, predators means somebody who wants to make you prey. Who wants to make you prey. That is a predator. Now there are predatory journals. And in fact, I know it is unfortunate that our country had one of the biggest predatory journal house in Allahabad, in Hyderabad. Now what has happened is they have been blacklisted and there is an issue there, major issue. So I would say never publish in a predatory journal. Because if you publish in predatory journal repeatedly and anybody is viewing your profile, what would happen is they will say, oh, this is that kind of fellow who publishes in predatory journal. Because if you publish 10 good paper in good journal and 10 paper in predatory journal, whenever somebody looks at your CV, you'll be rated very low. So most of these journals which ask for money, at least not most, many of them or some of them are predatory journals. So you can now go to UGC site, that is University Grant Commission site. They have listed all the journals which are not approved by them. Second is also MCI as an NMC has the same sort of system. They have also listed these are the predatory journal. So they will not consider this as your publication for any promotion or anything. So second is if let us say, how can you have this sort of money? Let us see if you have a funding agency. And when you are proposing a research project, suppose if you allot, let us say 2 lakh rupees as a publication fees or 3 lakh rupees as a publication fees. Now you have that much money to spend for a journal. There are some journals which are not predatory, but they are open access. They ask for money. So you can pay that. Because if you have. Also, I have an issue, which is a little my personal opinion, that if you publish a lot of paper giving money or sending the money from my country or our country to somewhere else, maybe we are weakening our economy. So I would not encourage that. I would not say it is a good practice. What you should do is that do good work, show that without paying money, you can publish. And there are hundreds of journals where there is no payment required for publication. Their criteria is only the novelty of your work or how good your work is. Okay? Now let us go to each system. Now, last time also I talked about this paper. So please read this paper. This details everything. And it is an open access paper. Therefore, you can download easily. So you can download free this paper and read. And here we have given opportunities, methods, and challenges. Today, I'm not going to talk about methods, but I'm going to talk about challenges and the opportunities. And I've already listed the challenges. Now, yes, please.
From the last year, Indian medical graduate, there is a time gap for the research for the undergraduate student from the last year.
No, that is very good. I think this is all what we have tried to do. In fact, some of these ideas MCI have adopted from our SGPGI curriculum. So we are very happy about it. Now we want implementation of this in a good way. So what I'm saying now, there is a lot of positive thing, but this should be implemented now, and implementation is at the hand of all of you. Now, I was listing, or I listed a lot of challenges. These are the challenges. But look at this gentleman. Okay? This gentleman said, you can call them problem, or you can call them challenges, or look at them as opportunity. So each time you have a problem or you have a challenge, actually that is the opportunity to catch. Okay? So let me see how we can convert our challenges in opportunities. I told first challenge was limited facilities of research, education, and training. And I'll tell you, whatever research I did, I owe a lot to SGPGI. You know why? Because when I came to SGPGI to do my DM training, in 1991, this is the only institute, perhaps only institute in the country, to the best of my knowledge, in which you had to take a 01 course. 01 course basically meant research methodology, biostatistics, and scientific communication course. Once you pass that course, then only you can sit in the DM examination. That means if you don't pass that course, you can't sit in the DM examination. There was nothing of this sort in MCI. And I remember some of the students really became upset, but the system was so good that whether you are upset or not, doesn't matter. You have to pass these courses, then only you can appear in the DM examination. Not that these courses made you master. These courses were only, or what I would say, by these courses I understood there is something which was missing in our MBBS curriculum, which was missing in our MD curriculum, and I need to learn. So much of the research methodology I learned after I completed my DM, but during DM, I could understand or learn my ignorance, that I'm ignorant about it. Now, that was the time then, 1991. Now, what is the advantage now? Anything is available online. You can go to any US universities and you will find some of their thing in online available free of cost. Suppose you are doing a statistical analysis and you have a problem, you can't understand this. Put in the Google, go to YouTube, and you'll find an expert is giving lecture on it, and you can beautifully understand. So this is the advantage of information technology that we have. So because of the information technology, you are not limited today by the boundaries of the institute or library. And I tell you, 20 years I'm in SGPGI, I hardly ever visited library in SGPGI. Now, you know why? Because library is at my home in my computer. So you can learn a lot of things online. Second is MCI and NMC has taken a big initiative. And I'm proud to say, happy to say, some of the program that we had in SGPGI, when we were doing DM in 1991, those have been transplanted to MBBS curriculum. And I was happy when my son entered into RG Corps Medical College. They said, we are having now something like 01 course. And he showed me the program, and I realized the program is the SGPK 01 course program. I said, very good. So you have offline training in each medical college. You have online availability, and it is an MCI and NMC initiative. Thanks to NMC. Second is, earlier if we had to do statistical analysis, you always had to run to a statistician. But nowadays, you have a lot of statistical software, so you may not be a statistician, still you can use it. So it is an opportunity. You have national support, like you open this site. This is nmc.in. This is nmc.in. So this is the site which is run from SGPGI. It is NMC site, NMCN. NMCN.in. 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 So this is NMCN.in. National Medical College Network.in. So NMCN.in. You visit, I would say you make it your default page. So make nmcn.in your default page of the computer so that whenever you open the internet, Google does not open. nmcn.in opens. So you'll see a lot of online material. Even many of these lectures are being recorded and put in the NMCN site. So you can have a lot of learning material. Second is, I told funding is a real problem. Am I right or am I wrong? Any opinion on that? That in India,
you are right.
Yes, very good.
Because funding is not available.
Okay, now this is the slide that shows that. This slide, you see, this is it is a little difficult to read. This is 100 euro, this is 200 euro, this is 300 euro. And then they have listed that government research and development spending. Top 20 countries per person per year. This is top 20 countries per person per year. Norway tops the list. Then comes the Austria, then comes the Luxembourg, then comes the Iceland, then United States, Sweden, Finland, Denmark, Switzerland, France, Netherlands, Australia, Germany, South Korea, Canada, Ireland, Spain, UK, then Slovenia and Japan. India is nowhere. India is nowhere. So are you depressed? Any reactions?
Yes,
to
sir,
this
definitely.
Okay,
sir, definitely this,
but can this be an opportunity for us? Interesting. We don't have money. Can them not having money be made into an opportunity?
In one way, we can do a lot of clinical research in which there is no hardcore technology or hardcore material involved, in which money is involved. We can do a lot.
But Dr. Ajay, I tell you, it is difficult. I realize it is difficult. You know why? When we want to do clinical research, you have to record the data. And I remember Dr. Manish said, recording data is difficult. So if you have to see 100 patients a day, where is the time that I'll sit with a patient for half an hour and fill up a questionnaire? So what I find is I need manpower for that. I need manpower who'll sit with me in the OPD, and whatever patient I see, if I find this is the patient on which I'm doing research, I will like that patient to be seen by one of my research assistant will take the pro forma based data. Number two, even I tell you, if I am not doing research on a disease, still I need the data, because if I have to see a patient in 5 or 10 minutes, it is difficult. I need at least half an hour to see a patient, which I don't have. So therefore, I myself will see 8 to 10 minutes, and then remaining 20 or 30 minutes, I will want somebody from my team to see the patient and come back to me saying that I've seen him or her, and this is the problem, this is questionnaire, I've filled up the questionnaire. And you cannot let your resident do that, because resident is also a doctor. He has done MBBS, he has done MD. This is a skilled manpower who has to see. We have 200 to 250 patients to be seen in the outpatient in a day. So that means if we have 6 resident, I'm the faculty 7, we together we have to see 250 patients. So you need money. I need a manpower to do that. But I can make it an opportunity. Look at this. $1 is equal to 70 rupees. So if I can fetch fund from outside the country, I have done my job. From outside, let us say today, I got a fund from UK. They sent $6,000 only, £6,000. They sent £6,000. £6,000 is a small amount of money to them, very little. But for us, it translates to about 6 lakh, around 5 to 6 lakh. So that fellow gives a small amount of money as a research support to his friend or collaborator, or maybe that group is a well-wisher for our research. Now that got changed to 6 lakh rupees. And this project we have written, it will total cost is 15 lakh rupees only. Now they said we'll give in 3 installments. So this is coming from UK. Now what I am saying is this is an opportunity. So you have to fetch more fund from outside your country. Now how to do that? How do you do that, Dr. Ajay?
I'm sorry, I don't have any idea.
Any thought anybody has on this? Any thought?
Suppose, Dr. Ghoshal, you give me 5 lakhs for research purpose from the ICMR, but I am servicing a medical college. So who will be my grantor? This is one of the problems.
No, I'll tell you, I'm going to come to National Funding Agency. National Funding Agency, ICMR, DST, DBT, CSIR, and all those. I'll tell you, their grant amount is much bigger because these are government bodies. The smallest grant amount from them would be around 50 lakh, let us say. Okay, 50 lakh. But this fund came from an UK, Bowel Disease UK. The name of this granting agency is called Bowel Disease UK, which is a charity in UK. It runs on donation. So they receive donation and they give that donation to other. But then you have to show your high quality work, because when they find that he's in a developing country doing high quality research in the whole world, which are meaningful to the whole world, they will tend to give you. Second is, yes, if you do good work, you get CSIR funding, you get ICMR funding, you get DST, DBT funding. Only thing is you have to do very good work. Second is, research can be performed in India at a much lower cost than in the West. Like my fellows are listening, rather my research students or research scholars are listening to this talk. Their salary varies between 10,000 rupees to 30,000 rupees a month. It's a very small amount for any person working in Singapore or US or UK. Like if you have to hire a fellow in Singapore, you have to pay at least 1 lakh to 1.5 lakh rupees Indian equivalent money. So that means you have to pay Singapore dollar, the equivalent would be 1 to 1.5 lakh minimum, because otherwise you can't survive in Singapore. The cost is high there. So is it an opportunity, Dr. Ajay?
sir. Yes, sir. Definitely, sir.
Very good. So now you agree with me that this challenge is an opportunity.
Yes.
Let me take an example. You can see this person. The picture looks that I'm a little younger. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So this is in Honolulu in 2005. In 2005, in Honolulu, Hawaii, I went for a conference. And I visited the stall of American College of Gastroenterology. I visited because in the conference you get all the drug companies giving their stall or making their stall. Similarly, American College of Gastroenterology makes its stall and all those. Now, what happened is when I went to that American College of Gastroenterology stall, I found that there is a leaflet which says, apply for SCG research grant. Okay? Apply for SCG research grant. So I thought, let me try. But at that time, I thought, if I apply for SCG grant, would they give me a grant when I'm working only in India? So let me have a collaborator in US. So there is a person whose name is Mark Pimentel. I read his paper earlier. He's now a good friend of mine. So I read his paper earlier. I approached Mark Pimentel and I said, would you like to collaborate with me on a project that I'm writing to going to submit to SCG? And he said, yes, okay. Now, while my return journey from US to Heathrow Airport in London, and then from Heathrow to Delhi, I kept on working on my computer, to write a research grant, because only I had 6 to 7 days time to finish the research grant. So I submitted in 7 days time, the research. Now their system was, look at this. This is the research grant. The co-investigator include Ujjwala, Dr. Rama Mittal, and Mark Pimentel. And can you see the amount fund requested? This is US dollar, $35,000. $35,000. So $35,000 in those days would be around maybe 10 or 12 lakh rupees. 12 lakh Indian rupees. Then what I did is, I thought they will not give it. Because why should they give? Now what happened is I made a phone call to the SCG office. And I said, I've submitted. Let me know if you need anything else. So they said, okay. Let the reviewer see. And then after this review meeting was over, I again made a phone call because I was at that time young and very curious to know what would happen to this research grant. And what happened is they said your project was discussed. And they said in this amount of money, they can't do it. It is impossible to do such a work in that much money. We can't even imagine. This work to be done in US in a money 20 times of this. Okay. So the letter said that the project is over ambitious and therefore we are not putting this as a priority project. You know, it doesn't say it is a bad project. It said it's a very good project. In fact, it is an over ambitious project. Because then I called them, they said, I said, in India, it is possible to do. They said, no, they could not believe that. They could not even believe that. That in India or wherever, it is not possible to do. So therefore, I submitted this grant to DST, Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. So now because SCG said it is overambitious, therefore it is not priority for us, I submitted this grant to DST. And DST sanctioned it. And after it was sanctioned, we completed the work and three beautiful papers, some for the first time in the world. This study is first time in the world for such concept, the upper left corner study, a proof of concept study. Now, this study has been reproduced now by Mark Pimentel in US, just maybe last year, 2019 or 2018, okay? Because in DST, Mark was not a collaborator because government funding agency in India would not consider him as a collaborator. So therefore, I could not put Mark as a collaborator when I submitted to DST. And now Mark has reproduced this study in US. So could it be made into an opportunity, Ajay? Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Now, let us go to other challenge. Somebody said we have to see a lot of patients. And this is the usual OPD of the India. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So now from this OPD, as you said rightly, you can get huge number of patients. And that will help you to finish your research project faster. Okay? Now, if you do not take research as an important agenda, then you will be like, look at there, the farmer is doing all the agriculture, but the fellow who is gaining is McDonald's. So farmer is farming all the potato, a lot of hard work, but every credit is going to McDonald's. Similarly, you will do so many patients. You are working so hard, you are risking your life in the corona days, but you are not being rated in the nation as one of the important workers. Okay? So you have some opportunities now. What are the opportunities? We have developed economically. There is no doubt. Yes, during corona day, our economy is down. Somebody said technology-driven research and technologies are lacking in India. I tell you, now there is a very little technology gap between India and US. You have huge and unique clinical material. You have high level of skill because skills comes from the volume. If your hands and your brain is right, then if you do less volume, you will not be skilled. If you are more volume, you will be more skilled. Look at China, they produce so much literature. When I go to China, you go for shopping, it is so difficult. They don't understand English at all. But in India, knowledge in English is better. Okay? DNB Council and MCI Council now make publication as mandatory. So therefore, these are opportunities. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Any point here? Anybody here? Alisa Pani Pila. Any point? Tushar, any point till now? Okay, I go now. I go forward. Yes, slow system. I know you will say system is slow. Second is ethical issues. What are the ethical issues? Sham Institute don't have ethics committee. Are there anybody who is listening? Is there anybody who is listening to me? And he would say, or she would say, there is no ethics committee in their institute. Is there anybody of that type? Does everybody listening and to me has an ethics committee? Okay, so it seems everybody has. Now you have to publish in right time. You have to publish in right time. And I'm giving an example. Now when corona came, there was a lockdown for 1 month in the whole country. And during this lockdown, obviously hospitals were all locked down. That is, you don't have OPD, you don't have endoscopy, you don't have ward duty. Because there is no admission to the ward. Country is locked down. Except corona patient, there is no admission in the gastroenterology OPD. Corona patient are going to corona hospital. So we took this opportunity and we submitted 4 or 5 research projects. This is one of the initial submissions that I made. and it was funded by Department of Biotechnology, Government of India. Now, what we did is the initial 16,000 PCR, that our COVID lab under leadership of Dr. Ujjwala Ghoshal. So our COVID lab in the first 1 month, that is May, April to May, did 16,000 PCR. Of these 16,000 PCR, 252 were positive. Okay? Now what happened is, each PCR result would be found positive. We from gastroenterology will make a phone call to that patient and fill up a pro forma, fill up a questionnaire, because you can't see those patients. You know, only their sample came from the district. So in the COVID lab, what came is their sample from the district through Integrated Disease Surveillance Program, IDSP. So these are not all SGPGI samples. In fact, of 16,000 tests that Dr. Ujjwala or her lab did, actually 3,000, about 3,000 were from SGPGI samples, and 13,000 were from district through Integrated Disease Surveillance Program. Okay? Now this patient, their sample only came, patient did not come. But with the sample, there is an ICMR pro forma which made it mandatory to give the phone number of the patient. So the moment a patient comes positive, we gastroenterologists, me and Dr. Akash Mathur, makes a phone call to the patient and then fills up a questionnaire. Now, once the questionnaire is filled up on paper, then Susmita, who is a research fellow working with me, she actually puts it everything digital. And every work completed in 1 month time, April to May. On 17th May, I analyzed the data. 17th May, I analyzed the data. Now, by last week of the June, we submitted this paper to GATT. GATT has an impact factor of 19. But GATT said already they have published such paper because China did before us. Chinese had an epidemic coming to their country maybe in November, but our epidemic came in February. So they have already submitted such manuscript and GATT has already accepted it. So it came back from the GATT. Then we sent to American Journal of Gastroenterology. They did not take this paper, but they suggested we can go to their sister journal, and this is Clinical and Translational Gastroenterology. So in 1 month time, we made submission to three journals, and then Clinical and Translational Gastroenterology took it. Now this paper, if it was the first paper in the world, it would have surely got to GATT or Lancet. So what I'm saying is, heat the iron when it is hot. So any point there, Dr. Ajay or Dr. Tusar, because in my opinion, sometimes we sit over the data, we don't analyze, and we don't write quickly. Am I right or am I wrong?
But this type of information from the microbiology department, can we get? It is also ethical issue, because they're not disclosed it outside.
Okay, what do you do, sir?
We cannot collect data from our...
I gave only an example. And obviously our system is like a DPT funded project, and the department signs that they will give that support, and second is director also signs that such support will be extended, and every fellow who worked in the project are co-authors. Look at this. In this project, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 co-authors. This is very important. If you want to collaborate, recognize your collaborator's contribution. If you want to collaborate, recognize your collaborator contribution. And what I'm telling you is that here, Dr. Ujjwala Ghosal is the joint first author. Because it was a DBT project, funded project, and I was the principal investigator, that's why I put myself first. Others, I would have put her the first, but she's joined first. She has done all the laboratory work. We did all the clinical data collection. I did all the analysis and writing. So what I'm saying is you have to develop a research culture. Now, Tushar brought in a very important question, and I'm coming there. Lack of research culture. He said, lack of research culture. This is a challenge. Can this be made into an opportunity? Opportunity is given in your slide. Surround yourself with like-minded people. Surround yourself with like-minded people. Because you have limited time. If you have enthusiasm to do work, now you see who is the one who is going to support you. Now, if somebody doesn't support you, leave him alone. Do not make him an enemy. But what I am saying is that he doesn't want to collaborate with you. Fine. Everybody has to make their own choices. But you surround yourself with the people who are like-minded, who want to contribute to the science. Now, second there is when I say like-minded, today in the digital technology, you don't have to be surrounded only with people within your department, but you can collaborate with people in the country and collaborate with people in the world. Okay, I think that gives Dr. Tushar answer. Second is limited health information. Look at this study, very interesting study. This study was done in UK. So what these people did is, they went to 21,714 children who was 4 years old in the country or in the city. So they just went to, they looked at, that today they looked at, I want to see, let us say you are doing this study, they did this study in 2016, published maybe 2015 they did it. So in 2015 they said, I want to get the information about all the children who were born in 2011. So in 2015, they decided that we want to get the name of all the children who were born in UK in 2011. Okay, is it possible to get that, Dr. Ajay?
Yes, sir.
Because you have census now, you have birth record, you have death record. Now, only thing is that our record is not as good, but we are becoming better. Don't think that we are not progressing. Country is progressing like anything. Now, what I'm saying is, what they did is, in 2015, they decided we want to get the information of all the children who were born in 2011. They got this. And then they went to these children just by phone call or any other means. They wanted to know what is their weight and height now. And they saw that 6% of these children who were born in 2011 became obese. 94% are lean, 6% are obese. Okay? Now they went to the health record of these children and tried to see who are the one who received antibiotic before second year of age. Then they did a logistic regression analysis to see is there a relationship between antibiotic exposure in the childhood before 2 years of age and development of obesity. Interesting study. Can be done in 3 months' time or 6 months' time. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So is it interesting? So can we do that? Such study? I'll tell you, you'll say there is an inadequate healthcare record. But look at this. Now, the digital health record is coming very soon. And this is called eHealth India. There is national portability of data, national privacy and consent management. unique health ID, which is called UHID, standards and regulation, and electronic health record. And never undermine, when we did this study, we got the samples from IDSP, Integrated Disease Surveillance Program, which many countries don't have. Even US may not have as good IDSP as we have. I don't know whether they have it or not, but at least the way US had a health crisis because of Corona, I suspect there must have been something which is not as good there. So Digital Health India, eHealth India, will make availability of such record. So this is an opportunity. Then collaboration. Now we are collaborating with many people in the world on digestive disease research. I collaborate with people of around 34, 35 countries. So collaboration is key to the success. Now there is another problem. Lack of incentive for research. But now you are getting incentive. That means what happens is now NMC, MCI made a system that if you did not publish, it will be difficult to promote. That is, those who have published have an advantage because they would be easily promoted. Second is government is now talking about patent. So when patenting system becomes better, your ideas can give you royalty also, maybe in future. Yes? Any point here? Anybody has to share? Any point anybody has to share? Do you think there is a publication bias? So do you think there is a publication bias?
Yes,
definitely. So what is the solution for publication bias, if there is any?
We should start our own national journals.
Very good. Now here is it. There are good national journals. Even I am a gastroenterologist. I have given gastroenterology examples, but there are more national journals. So don't say we should start. We have already. Yes. So instead of starting, you strengthen it. When you write paper, cite your own country's data. Cite your own country's data, cite your own journal. So our predecessor has already done it. There are good journal, Indian Journal of Gastroenterology, Journal of Digestive Endoscopy, Clinical and Experimental Hepatology. Our predecessor have already done it, but it is our job to strengthen this. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So we should not try to rediscover the wheel. The wheel has already been discovered. Let the wheel be better. Aim high. English is your positive side. And look at this, you have to market your research. When you market your research, you not only market yourself, you market your journal, you market your country. So we all use social media. Like in China, you see there is a constraint of using social media. You know that very well. Okay? So in the social media, don't give all those posts which doesn't matter to you. Like, we are not politicians. Okay? So it doesn't matter to you what is happening in the politics. But education matters to us. Science matters to us. Research matters to us. So give your post. You will hardly ever find that in my Facebook account, I've given something which is like a sort of all those which I was talking earlier.